The outcome of the Indiana Attorney General race could impact the debate about legalizing marijuana in Indiana. Thank you for choosing us. I'm Brian McElhatt.
And I'm Krista Miller. The Democrat running for the office visited Fort Wayne today, drawing attention to differences he has with the Republican on the ballot.
Jeff Neumeyer's live from the Memorial Coliseum, where early voting is taking place. He's here with more, Jeff.
Yeah, Brian, Krista, Jonathan Weinzapfel knows it has been nearly a quarter century since a Democrat has held the job as Indiana's chief legal officer, but he hopes to change that after the votes are counted in this race. Now, Weinzapfel, a former state lawmaker and mayor of Evansville, met today with Allen County voters waiting in line to do early voting. He supports more expansive rights for people to vote by mail, especially during the pandemic. Republican Todd Rokita has said maintaining absentee voting under specified restrictions, as has been the rule in Indiana, is the right way to go. Weinzapfel says a major issue where he differs from Rokita is on the idea of decriminalizing marijuana.
I think we ought to legalize it, regulate it, tax it, use the proceeds to support pay raises for teachers, to support law enforcement. He wants to continue to lock people up in jail for possession of marijuana. So it, clear differences like that that really, I think, paint a pretty vivid picture of who would be the best attorney general for the state of Indiana.
Brent Littlefield, a strategic advisor for the Rokita campaign, says Rokita fully supports current Indiana law for a judge to issue a conditional discharge for first-time small marijuana possession offenses. He called out Weinzapfel for, quote, soft on crime stances on marijuana and elimination of bail, something Rokita's camp says has led to more violent crime in states like New York. A new Weinzapfel TV ad says Rokita is bound and determined to overturn the Affordable Care Act, and that Rokita's gone on the record saying Medicare eligibility shouldn't start until age 78. The Rokita campaign denying that, saying he has received awards for his support of Social Security and Medicare, and saying that, quote, Weinzapfel is grasping at straws with his false attacks. We'll know the winner on Election Day. That's November the 3rd. Brian and Krista, or maybe someday soon after, if in fact we don't get all those votes counted the first day.
Yeah, maybe more like election week. We'll see how all that goes. Jeff, thank you very much.